Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to learn what is JSON and why it is used, what it is used, and we will also see a very basic demo. This is going to be very easy and very interesting. I will start from scratch, and if you have never understood JSON or if it is the first time you are hearing this word, do not worry. After this video, you will know everything about JSON and we will go from scratch and I will go up step by step. Let us take an example. Let us say we have two machines or two computers and they want to talk to each other or exchange data. The first computer says, I can work with two programming languages, Java and Python. How many languages can you work with? The second computer does not understand this way of communication. So the first computer says, let us design a common syntax, a structural formatted way of representing data so that all computers can understand it. And the second computer has no idea what is going on. So the first computer designs a formatted way of exchanging data. So we have two curly braces here. Then we have a tag called languages and then a square bracket start and stop. Then we have the first data set, that is the information about the first language within curly braces, and then we have the second data, that is the information about the second language. And now this is a very well formatted and a very well structured way of representing data, and our second computer understands this and he responds back with the languages he can work with. Now this way the two computers are able to communicate and also exchange data. Now this is a hypothetical example, but the format of communication we just saw is called JSON. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation, and it is a way of communicating data with specific rules or a specific syntax and a structure like XML and YAML. JSON is another way of communicating data. It uses key value pairs, and then the syntax is taken from JavaScript. That is why it is called as JavaScript Object Notation. But JSON is portable with multiple languages, so you can use JSON with almost all the languages. Now this information is coming from json.org, which is the official website of JSON. JSON is a lightweight data interchange format. It is easy for humans to read and write, as we have just seen. Even humans can read and write JSON, and machines can easily parse and generate a JSON message or a JSON document. And it is based on the subset of Java programming language, and that is why it is called as JavaScript Object Notation. Now, JSON is built on two structures. If we talk about the structure of JSON, and once I show you a demo, this will be even more clear. But just to understand the basics, these are the two structures, a collection of name value pairs and an ordered list of values. A collection of name value pairs is called object and ordered list of values is called array. So these are the two basic structures in a JSON message or a document, object and arrays. And most of the programming languages use these two structures in some way or the others, like object can be realized as an object, record, structure, dictionary, hash table in programming languages. And in most languages, array can be realized as an array, vector list or sequence. And that is the reason all modern, most of the programming languages support these two data structures in one way or the other, and therefore they can also understand and work with JSON. Now, if I talk about object, here an object is an unordered set of name value pairs, and it always begins with a curly brace and ends with a curly brace, and then every name is followed by a colon, and after every name value pairs you will find a comma, or the name value pairs are separated by comma. Let us see our example of languages. Here you can see we have languages and then we have these objects under the languages. So here this is one object which is within the curly braces, and then this is the second object. So we have two objects in this JSON. If we go to the array now, array is an ordered list of values, and here it begins and ends with a square bracket, and the values are separated by a comma. If you look at our example on the right, here languages is an array in this JSON, and you can see it starts and ends with a square bracket, and we have a single array in this JSON. If we had multiple arrays, we would have a comma after the end square bracket, and we could have other arrays as well. And we can also say that the languages array holds two objects in this JSON. So these are the two basic structures, but then there are other types. We have already seen objects, which is key value pairs, and they can be strings or any numbers or any objects in this key value. So the key is usually a string which is within quotes, and the value can be a string which will come under quotes, or it can also be a number. So here we have age equals 35. Now 35 is a number, so it is not in quotes. So these are the objects. Then we can have arrays. They can be numerical arrays, string arrays, or any other object arrays. Then we can have strings in JSON. So strings will come under quotes. Then we can have numbers. We can have simple numbers, decimal numbers, negative numbers, or even scientific numbers we can have in JSON. We can also have Boolean types in JSON, that is true and false, or we can have null values in a JSON. So this was about the JSON types. Now if we talk about very simple rules of creating a JSON, the data is in name value pairs, as we have seen. Data is separated by commas, curly braces hold objects, and square brackets hold arrays. So these are the simple rules for creating a JSON message. Now let us see a very simple demo, so it will be very clear to you. I am going on my Windows system, and you can use any editor that can work with JSON, like Visual Studio Code. Here I am just creating a very simple text file. I will say new and a text document, and I will say this is demo, and the extension I will give is JSON. So here you can see I have created a simple file with an extension as JSON. Now you can open this file in any of the editors that can work with JSON. I am using Notepad++. You can use Visual Studio Code or any other editor. And here I will create a very simple JSON document or a JSON message. So it will start with a curly brace and end with a curly brace. Inside this curly brace, I will create an array. So I will create an array for users, and then I will give a colon, and as we know, it starts with a square bracket and it will end with a square bracket. So now users is an array, and we can now create data for this array. And again, I am going to use curly braces. Here for the first set of data, I will say first name and a colon, and I will say first name is Graham. And now for the second data, I will give a comma here, and then I will say last name, and I will say this is Bell, and then again comma, and then I will say age, and here I will say age is 30. So this is one data set or one object of this array. Now I can create multiple data or multiple objects. I'm just going to copy this object and give a comma here and then paste it again. So we have the second object. I will say this is first name is Isaac and Newton, and I will give the age. So now you can see here we now have these two objects in the users array, and this is a valid JSON. Now if I want to add more arrays, like users is one array, I will go to the end and give a comma here, and let's just say I will create one more array called subjects, and again I will give a colon and then a square bracket start and a square bracket stop. And inside the square bracket, I can give my objects within curly brackets or curly braces. So here I will say name and colon, and the value is, let us say, automation. And I can also give the ID to this subject. Let us say 1. Then I can create one more subject here. I will say name is JSON and ID is 2. So here you can see this is a valid JSON where we have two arrays, users and subjects. User array has two objects and subject array also has two objects. Now if I want, let us say I want to add hobbies of the user, I will say hobbies, and then if I have to add multiple hobbies, I can again give an array here and I can say reading, and then I can say comma and writing, and I can keep on adding the values here. So here I'm using an array for the value of this particular hobbies tag. And then if I want to add something like friends of this user, I will say friends, and then I can use an array, and within the array I can add objects. So I can again say here I will give a curly braces start and stop, so here I will say first name and I will say here Isaac. And then I will say last name. Newton. So if you see here, I can do nesting as well. So here we can do nesting between arrays and objects like this. And this is all valid. And you can save this. And here, even I can give a subject ID for a user. So all this will work. This is a valid JSON, and just in case you want to create a local JSON server or start a JSON server and run this and check on the browser, you can do that as well. And just in case you want to learn that, you can go on my website automationstepbystep.com, and here you will see a section for API mocking and how to mock APIs. If you go here, this will take you to a YouTube playlist, and on this YouTube playlist you can see how you can create a fake REST API for testing using the JSON server. So using JSON server, you can also run this JSON, which is actually, you can say it as a REST API where we have added all this information. So this is how you can very easily create a JSON. And I hope now you know what is JSON, why we use it, and how we can create a JSON. I hope all this was very useful for you. I will meet you in the next session. Thank you for watching.